cooking tea, she will be there. And they will give something to her. After 6 years, the mother reappeared. That is when the girl and the siblings knew that the mother was arrested. And immediately when the mother came back, the siblings, there were four. She was the third one to her mother. The two of them there, the third one and the last one, they were taken to somewhere in the Eastern Cape, in a place called Madadiere. Because the mother lost the house, the Soweto house, to a friend that was coming somewhere from Durban. The mother used to have a very good heart, so she would take everybody that is coming from wherever. Eventually, she lost the house to this woman who was coming from Durban. The mother was hopeless. She took the little kids together with survivor to a place called Matatiel. The survivor was the oldest to the youngest. You can imagine. You can imagine abuse of any kind. You can imagine survivor and the younger sister having to go and look for wood late at night. They would be sent to go and fetch water late at night. To cut the long story short, around 1970, that was in the 70s, around 1979, now survivor has completed standard 7, and she didn't have money to go to school there because you can only go to a boarding school. The family from the mother's side, they were all educated. They were policemen, they were nurses, they were teachers, but no one could come up and say, I will take this child to school, to a boarding school. Then the mother felt that survivor must come back with the younger sister. She came back. That was around 1979. Immediately after that, okay, she went to school, did her standard 8 until matric, she passed the matric. Immediately when she passed the matric, the mother died. Immediately when survivor passed matric, the mother died. Survivor went to look for work. And when she went to look for work, unfortunately she was pregnant. She went to look for work somewhere in a hospital that I won't call the name. You know, they felt pity for this little survivor. The clerks that were there, then they hired survivor. She started working there in that hospital as a cleaner. She cleaned, man. She cleaned. And she was promoted to a ward helper. Because the survivor had matric, remember? And survivor could speak English. And the nurses in the ward would send survivor to the matrons. And survivor would speak with the matrons. By then, survivor is this short. When we talk of pulling her down syndrome, women, we are experts on that. You don't know this little girl. They didn't know this little girl. She was making tea. She was cleaning the ward. And the sisters that were working there, they would just spill the tea and say, where's the auntie to come and clean? It's us women. I'm sharing a very personal story that inspires me every day. Then the survivor worked there. She became a general assistant. She worked around her way. She was promoted to a clerk at one stage. Post 94, because survivor was now almost 23 years. At that time, unfortunately, as a black person, you were getting a school leaving certificate, it's a matric. For exemption, matric, it was a particular number. So survivor had a school leaving. You could apply at a university only when you were 23 years. Then survivor applied post 94. She went through to UNISA, I'm told. She went through to UNISA to study probably HR. By the way, during the school days, Survivor was in Kosas. She was very chacharach because she had to hustle. At the age of 10, she worked in the Eastern Cape doing washing for the aunties so that she can get a little money to buy handwork. So she was a survivor. She's a survivor, the name. And she's a hustler. So she went through to school. She got a post as a clerk. She felt diamond because she was now working as a clerk. And she's studying towards HR, isn't it? Then she felt that, let me just apply a staff office. Those of you who are older than me, like me, ne? We didn't know HR, but then we knew staff office. She was appointed at staff office. She worked at staff office probably for 9 months in HR. After 9 months in HR, she said, I'm taking this one. She became a manager in HR. I don't know, I'm not going to tell you where. And then she became a manager in HR. She did her thing. She's a survivor. She's been there. She's been in COSAS as a secretary at COSAS, you say Yova. She's been a shop steward. Then she was promoted along the way. I want to cut this story very short, but I want all of you to touch something that will make you to be strong in this story. It mixes a lot of things. As women, we go through a lot of things. This very survivor survived 2 attempted rapes in Matatiele at the age of 11 years. She survived 2 attempted hureta. It was huge, that thing of rattling people and taking their parts. This survivor girl, little girl, survived those 2 rapes. She survived 2 attempted murder. Okay, I'm coming back now. She's now being an HR manager somewhere. But she felt good, as in, she would look at people and say, if they can do it, I can also do it. Yes. Nah. Yes. If you can do it, why not me? If we are still blaming apartheid, what did you do post 94? I'm actually challenging. I'm an EPWP. You don't have to go around ufake leyo overall orange. Tell yourself, this is a stepping stone. I'm actually coming back to manage this hospital. Women,